I'm assuming everybody that watches this video has played a zombie game sometime in their life. With the plethora of zombie games coming out seemingly every month now, it's pretty easy for the good ones to get overlooked. Well, not today, my friends. What is up? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome to Chaos Top 10s. And today, we are going to be counting down the top 10 zombie games that everyone, including yourself, should play at least once. Now, I know most of you are diehard gamers, so you've probably played every one of these on the list. And if you have, you let me know in the comment section. Drop a like on the video, and away we go. At number 10, we have Zombies Ate My Neighbors. And this is kicking off our list. It's a classic Konami game for the Super NES and the Sega Genesis, and this game is just plain fun. A straightforward run-and-gun zombie game, this is one of the earliest games in the genre, released all the way back in 1993. It wasn't a great commercial success, but its legacy still lives on today thanks to its gameplay that was very deep and rich and way ahead of its time, and the great writing that still holds up even today. I mean, this game is like almost 30 years old, and it's still a very fun experience. At number 9, we have DayZ, a game with an awesome premise that kind of fell apart once people actually started playing it. DayZ is supposed to be an open-world multiplayer game where people interact with each other to hunt for food and resources in the wake of a zombie apocalypse. Well, that's what it started out as. But it ended up being a paradise for cheaters, trolls, and let's just face it, assholes. Granted, the DayZ that people are playing today is actually an early alpha and will supposedly be fixed up before the official release, but it's also been in early access since 2013. So the chances of it actually being finished are pretty slim. What would be next, an actual beta and then the launch? If you ask me, this is pretty much the final version you are going to get. And this number 8 selection probably could have been higher. Definitely had to be on the list. I'm sure a lot of people will agree. Left 4 Dead 2. And this is a team-based zombie shoot-em-up game from Valve. The first one was absolutely great. Don't get me wrong. But for the full Left 4 Dead experience, the sequel gets the whole package. Funny characters, fun gameplay, brutal combat, defending safe zones, awesome multiplayer. Left 4 Dead 2 is just awesome in my opinion. It's also still pretty well populated online, so if you've never played it, even though it's a really old game, definitely go pick up a copy. It's still crazy fun, and you can still party up with people to this day and experience this zombie game. At number 7, and I've never actually played this game, State of Decay. If you've ever wondered what it would be like to be in a zombie apocalypse with limited resources, this game definitely gives you that experience. From what I've heard, this one puts you actually in the mix. The game really has it all. Stealth, open world, shooters, action, leadership, defense. State of Decay is supposedly the ultimate realistic zombie apocalypse experience. Maybe like a Walking Dead-esque feel to it. The sequel is set to release later this year and is rumored to add multiplayer to make things even deeper. And if it does, and they do bring multiplayer to this, this could be one of the most popular titles of next year if they do it right. A lot of classics on this list today. And at number 6, we have House of the Dead. Pure classic, no way around it. House of the Dead is one of the greatest arcade games of all time, and arguably the best light gun game ever. That's right, light gun. Do you guys remember the light guns? Not all the way back to Duck Hunt, but in the arcades. In fact, House of the Dead is one of the earliest zombie shoot-em-up games ever invented. And if you ask me, it still holds up to this day. With the over-the-top violence and addicting, fast-paced gameplay, House of the Dead is just plain fun. Somehow, if you can, I know arcades aren't around anymore, but if you can get your hands on this with a light gun, go check it out. Get your hands on this some way, somehow, because I promise, if you're all about the nostalgia of classic shooters mixed with the zombie, you definitely want to play this. House of Dead is an instant classic that is still fun to this very day. At number 5, and one of my favorite games to this day, Call of Duty World at War. One of the main selling points of the modern Call of Duty games is now the zombies mode. Everybody in the community wants to know, what are we going to get zombies wise? We see new renditions from Sledgehammer. They did Exo Zombies. We now see crazy 70s and 80s and 90s zombies from Infinity Ward, but the classic Treyarch World at War zombies, Nazi zombies, is where it all began. With grim atmosphere, memorable characters, addicting gameplay, Call of Duty Zombies is tons of fun. To this day, people love this game. Now, World at War may not be your favorite entry in the zombie franchise, but if you enjoy COD Zombies, you should definitely go back and play the original in World at War to see where it all started if for some reason you haven't played this. But if you have, maybe you should just go back and revisit it anyway. I promise, you probably won't regret it. At number four, we have Red Dead Redemption Undead Nightmare. I have played all the way through this game. As if Red Dead Redemption wasn't awesome enough as it was, this expansion of the open world game added a new dimension of survival horror to the Wild West and also showed us Rockstar Studios' capabilities with horror. I can only hope that Red Dead Redemption 2 gets an expansion just like this one, Undead Nightmare 2. Seriously, who else would kill to see Rockstar make an open world horror game? Doesn't even have to be an expansion. Forget Red Dead, just a solo open world zombies game. Undead Nightmare takes everything great about the Red Dead Redemption and adds the zombies. What more could you ask for? Maybe with the upcoming game, we'll get that sequel that a lot of people are asking and wanting and hoping for. To me, that would be amazing. Number three is a very deserving spot for this title, Dead Rising. While other games in the zombie apocalypse genre tend to focus more on the serious side of future, Dead Rising takes players the other direction completely and brings a more lighthearted zombie killing experience with anything and everything the player can get their hands on. You can literally craft any type of weapon your little heart is content on crafting or your imagination can come up with. What other game, okay, can you attach chainsaws to a boat paddle and then sprint through hordes of zombies mowing down everything in your path? Ever ask your friends where you would go during a zombie apocalypse and they answer Costco or the department store? Well, guess what? Dead Rising takes that scenario and makes it absolutely fun as hell. This number two game could possibly be one of the greatest games of all time. I want to know in the comment section if you agree or disagree with that. It may determine if we're friends or not. The Last of Us, often called one of the greatest games of all time. There's a good chance you've already played The Last of Us, and that's good, because everyone should play and experience this game. With emotional storytelling, great characters, brutal combat, disturbing atmosphere, and terrifying enemies, The Last of Us is hands down one of the best games of the 21st century, and the gaming world couldn't be more excited for the sequel. Due out sometime in the next few years, hopefully sooner than later. And even though this one is very grim, very serious setting, it definitely needed to be on this zombie list. If you haven't played this, I implore you to go play it. At number one, can you guess this? Come on. Yeah, what game has not been on the list so far? And you probably, I see the comments already. If Resident Evil's not on this list, I'm not watching the video. Oh yeah, we're going way back for this last entry. Everyone knows the Resident Evil franchise, but not nearly as many have actually played the original game. What are you guys waiting for? With the seemingly countless remakes and releases for this classic, you can find it for pretty much any console. You can get your hands on the original in multiple different ways to experience it. With the fixed camera, eerie atmosphere, powerful enemies, and limited resources. When I say limited, I mean limited. The original Resident Evil definitely holds up this day on the scare factor meter. If you consider yourself an actual true avid zombie fan of zombie video games, or of just horror games in general, you owe it to yourself to give this game a shot if you never have. And there you have it, my friends. This is a list that we comprised for you of 10 zombie games that everyone should experience at least once in their lifetime. As always, drop a like on the video, be sure to follow Chaos Top 10s on Twitter, and subscribe to the channel. If you guys have any suggestions for new top 10s that you would like to see, let me know in the comment section and on Twitter, because we put up a brand new video game top 10 every day of the week. There is a playlist below as well if you guys want to check out all the other ones, catch up on them before the new one comes out for the day. And I want to say a big thank you to everybody for supporting this series, this channel. We just hit 50,000 subscribers. So in a couple days, look for a giveaway at the beginning of a video. I don't know what we're gonna give away, but you guys can suggest some things you'd like to see. Maybe G Fuel, Control Freaks, a new game, maybe a zombie game. You guys let me know and I'll make it happen, because I wanna say thank you to you guys for helping this channel grow. Hope you guys have a fantastic day. I'll be back tomorrow for another video.